Okay. seated. In just a moment, we're going to have communion. I just felt this week that this was what we were supposed to do, is just take time and give God thanks for who He is. In Matthew chapter 26, it gives us an account of what took place as they're getting ready to have the Last Supper. We understand prior to this that Judas has already agreed to betray the Lord. Then in verse number 17, says, on the first day of the festival of unleavened bread, guys, don't worry about the slides, we're good. On the first day of the festival of unleavened bread, the disciples came to Jesus and said, "Where do you want us to make preparations to eat the Passover meal?" You have to remember in the book of Exodus, there was a meal that was prepared, and it was the Passover meal. It was when they were told to prepare because the death angel was going to move through, and firstborn of all the families were going to die if there was not the blood on the two side posts of the door and over the door. Gives us symbolism of what is to come with the death of Jesus Christ. They've made this preparation, and now it's a time that they remember throughout history, and so this is where we are. They're getting ready. Jesus replied to them. He said, "Go into the city to a certain man and tell him, 'The teacher says, my appointed time is near. I'm going to celebrate the Passovers with my disciples at your house.'" Man, that one little phrase just rang out to me. Go and find this man and tell him, "I'm going to have Passover meal at your house." That "at your house" just kind of resonated in me. You see, I believe today the Lord is looking for a house that He can come and we can remember everything that He's done for us. We get so busy, you know. The word thanks is thrown around so much. Thanksgiving, you know, we come and when we think Thanksgiving, we think, well, what am I going to cook? You know, what am I going to cook? Who's going to come over? And we get in all the frenzy of everything. I woke up early Thanksgiving morning. I woke up about 2 o'clock that morning. And it was quiet at my house. And so I went in and I sat down and built a fire. And made a cup of coffee, and I just sat there. And I began to go through in my mind the people that have had an impact in my life, and I just began to tell the Lord, "I'm so thankful for these people, Lord. I'm so thankful." I went through, and there were some of you. I went through my family. I went through my board of directors, their spouses. I went through my staff and their spouses, and I went through a whole lot of different people, and I just sat there and listened to the fire and drank a cup of coffee, and I went, "You have been so good to me, Lord." During the times of loss, during the times of challenge, during all of those times, I can still see the goodness of God. And sometimes the Lord wants to come to our house and He wants to help us remember and prepare us for the things to come, but we're so busy. What if this guy had said, "Well, you know, I've got some people coming over. Or, you know, I'm really kind of busy." Jesus would have found another house. What happens when the Lord comes and says, I'd really like to come to your house and sit down with you, and let's remember all the things that I've done, and I want to prepare you for what is to come. Is your house available? You see, then he sat there with people that he knew was going to betray him. I was talking with Jake earlier. Jake's got a great message for next Sunday. I'm going to be out of town, and he was sharing with me, and I'm like, I don't care where I'm at. I'm turning your message on, because that's a God message. That's a God message, buddy. And we so many times want everything to be just right to give thanks. What have I got to be thankful for, man? The world's going to hell in a handbasket. You know, everything's wrong. Really? Is it? Did you just take a breath? Do you have a roof over your head? We're so thankful to have Alfred and Kylie with us. We love you guys, and we're so thankful for you. They're staying in our missions house over here. They were in Israel when the bombing started. Their family was able to get out. But Kylie did such a great job. We began to share some different things. And I'm not going to go into it because of sensitivity and everything. But we've got a lot to be thankful for today. There are not bombs falling around us. We're able to come into this house and have air conditioning. We're able to come in here and have power. There are people still digging, trying to find loved ones. And we're sitting here today, and sometimes we're sitting here with an ungrateful heart. Shame on you. Right? Can I say that as a pastor? Shame on us. I'm in that group also. Jesus sat there with the people he knew he was going to betray. He looked at Judas. He said, that thing that you're going to do, go and do quickly. He's getting ready to go into the garden. I think one of my favorite places in Israel when we were there with Alfred and Kylie was the Garden of Gethsemane. So many emotions. That could have been the point where he's like, no, I'm out. I'm out. Can't you even tarry with me just a little bit? Goes back, just travailing, coming back. Really? And I think Jesus is asking some of us, can you hang with me for an hour? Can you just hang with me in spite of everything that's going on? And then the Bible goes on and it talks about that as they got together at the supper, he broke the bread knowing what was coming. And the Bible said he gave thanks. He broke the bread knowing what was coming, and he gave thanks. You see, we don't know what's coming. We don't know what's coming down the pike. We don't know what all is going on. But today there is a reason to give thanks. Tomorrow, when things go haywire, there is a reason to give thanks. He broke the bread. He gave thanks. And then he gave it to the disciples. And he told them, my body's going to be broken. Remember this moment. Gave him the cup. My blood's going to be shed. Remember this moment. And for each one of us today, I want us to take some time And I want us to remember the goodness of God. I want us to remember what God has done for us and what God is preparing us for. It's a very simple service today. I've got other things written. I probably have two sermons written because I'm sitting here going, okay, God, where are you going? I'm trying to find this place of where you're at. And it was almost like the Holy Spirit, Reuben, told me, I'll tell you when you get there. And he did. He said, just tell him to love me. Just tell him to remember. And tell him, I'll never leave him. And I'll never forsake him. But I will always be with them to the very end. Because all my life, he has been faithful. So I want you, I want you to just pause and think about the goodness of God. Is there anyone in the house that did not receive communion container whenever you came in? If you didn't receive one, please raise your hand. We're prepared. Okay, raise them, hold them up. If you would like to, you don't have to, but if you'd like to, raise your hand, hold them up, and we have communion containers that are coming to you, okay? Raise them, hold them up so that we can make sure that we've got some coming this way. They're coming from all around. They're serving our team up here. Yeah, guys, go ahead and serve the team up here, if you will. Just hold on to them. Anyone else? We want to make sure if you want to participate in communion that you can. So go ahead and get it ready. So what you do is you just fold the little tab back, pull the plastic off, and then the top will come back also. And look at your neighbor and see if they need help, okay? If they need help, it's okay. Help them. Pocket knives are permissible. Okay? I know these are difficult, but it was one of those where I just felt last minute and I ran, thank the Lord for Dove Christian Supply still in Dothan, Alabama. If you need help, let us know. We'll be glad to help you. They're difficult, I know. Christmas, we won't be doing that. We may do something different. We'll see. Someone needs to go in the market and make these easier. And then give the money to Chrome. Those who can't be with us today that are watching online, my beautiful bride is at home again this Sunday. I've never known her to have to miss two Sundays. Be praying for her. She has a viral thing going on in her eyes, and it's just been miserable for her. So pray for her. I know there's others. Cindy is at home recuperating. There's a number of people that are there. And for those that are watching us online today, God bless you. If you want to find something to have communion with, it can be a goldfish cracker and sweet tea. It doesn't matter. It's not about what you use. It's about why you use it. Amen. So we tell people that all the time. They go, well, I didn't have anything. Well, break off a piece of bologna. It's all right. So today, guys, I need one, if you don't mind. look at you. You already got it open. What a man. Partially. Just take a moment. The goodness of God. Just take a moment. The goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful.
All my life you have been faithful.
Scripture tells us, 1 Corinthians chapter 11, says, "For I received from the Lord what I'm also passing on to you." The Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and he said, "This is my body, which is for you. When you do this, do it in remembrance of me." David, would you do us the honor of praying over the bread today? Would you stand and just pray today? He had given thanks. He took the bread, blessed it. He said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." You may take the bread. Jay, I'm going to put you on the spot. Jay has been healed miraculously. Head-on collision that should have taken his life. Couldn't pull the vehicles apart. He was supposed to be in the hospital months upon months upon months. Should not be even walking right now. Should not be doing anything that he's doing. But Jay is in the house of the Lord. And he's a testimony of the broken body that was given for healing. Jay, would you stand? Would you give thanks for the cup today?
Dear Lord, my body was broken. We've all been broken at times in this broken world. But you've given us a promise of greater things to look forward to. And we shall have them. But dear Lord, while we are here, let us endeavor to bless others, to remember our brokenness, and know that you are the ultimate healer. And I ask this in your holy name and ask you to give it and bless us and bring us forward into your arms more, even more.
Thank you, Jay. And they took the cup. He blessed it. And he said, "This cup is the new covenant." He was saying, no longer do you have to find somebody else. You can come boldly to me. Whenever you do this and whenever you drink it, do it in remembrance of me. For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. You may take of the cup.
Faithful. darkest night, you were close like no other.
You love me.
I've known you as a father, and I've known you as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness of God.
Come on, tell him how much you love him right now, will you? Goodness is running after me.
Your goodness is running after me. It's running after me. Yeah. Your goodness is running after me. It's running after me. With my life laid down, I'm surrendered now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running.
And now to him who is able to keep you from stumbling and to present you before his glorious presence without fault and with great joy. To the only God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, power, and authority through Jesus Christ our Lord, before all ages, and now and forevermore. And the church said, amen.